Hi guys, this is Nakul back with the honest review video of Micromax Canvas A1, which is an Android One device. Today I'm going to do an honest review video about this phone in my classic pros and cons style, basically what a normal day user would like and dislike in this phone. Plus also consider it as a review of Spice Dream Uno, which is also an Android One device. Both the devices are exactly the same in every way, so I thought why make a separate video for this device and why not include it in this single video. So I'll be reviewing this phone, Micromax Canvas A1, but you should also consider it as a review of Spice Dream Uno. So let's not waste any more time and get started. So firstly, I'll be telling about the pros of this phone, the good things, the things I like in this phone. And the first thing is its design and the way it feels in the hand. It has really nice curvy design, as you can see. There are no edges or sharp ends. It's all soft and curvy. And the back panel goes up to the side to around 75%, and as it's matte rubbery finish, so it feels really good and soft in the hand, grips really well in the hand, and it feels really soft and good in the hand. So that's the first thing I like about this phone. Okay, so moving on, the next thing I like about this phone is also related to its design, and that is the side buttons. As you can see here, power and volume rocker buttons, they have this good feel to them. They are really soft and doesn't move or anything, and it gives good feedback while you press them. Not very tight, not very soft, so I felt really good while pressing them. Unlike the side buttons of Moto G, which are a bit clumsy and move a bit, as you can see they are kind of loose and move a bit, there is nothing like this in this device. They don't move at all, they don't have any play or any clumsiness to it. They are very solid and feel good quality. Moving on, the next thing I like about this phone is the processor. The processor is 1.3 quad core MediaTek processor, which at this price is really good. I ran Antutu benchmark on it and it scored around 18,600, as you can see, 18,691, which is really good. It is almost as equal to Moto G second generation, which obviously has a bit lower processor than this 1.2 quad core, but that's Snapdragon and this is MediaTek. So at this price, 6,500 rupees, this is really nice. And the next thing is also related to processor and thing, it is the GPU. It has Mali 400 GPU, which scored even above than Acer Zenfone 5. As you can see, it scored 62.2 FPS, which is really good. Moto G scored 57 point something FPS, while Acer Zenfone 5 scored 60 point something FPS when I ran the Nina Mark II in them. So obviously this phone has better GPU than both of those devices. It scored higher FPS than them, so that's a really good thing, especially at this price. Moving on, the next thing I like about this phone is also the highlight of this phone, that it's coming with the latest Android 4.4.4 KitKat out of the box. So that's a really good thing, that a phone which is priced at 6500 rupees is coming with the Android 4.4.4 KitKat and will also get the future Android updates, because Google has promised us that this phone will get the latest Android update for up to 2 years, so that's a pretty good thing. Moving on, the next thing I like about this phone is the loudspeaker. As you all know, this phone has really tiny outlet, or you can say the grill of loudspeaker, so you don't really expect that this is gonna be loud and clear, but trust me guys, it is. I'll give you a demo. So as you guys just heard, that the loudspeaker is really clear and it's loud. Obviously it's not as loud as Moto G. You can't compare any phone's loudspeaker to Moto G, because Moto G has an exceptional loudspeaker. But still, this phone has a really good loudspeaker, which I really liked. In clarity, I would give it around 9 out of 10, and in loudness, I would give it around 7 out of 10. So that's pretty good. So the next thing I like about this phone is that it does have a brightness sensor up here. It means when you go out in direct sunlight or a brighter area, so the phone automatically turns up the brightness, so you don't feel any trouble while looking at the screen. And same as it turns up the brightness, when you go to a darker place, it automatically turns down the brightness so that it can save more battery. So that's pretty good. Moving on, the next thing I like about this phone is that it's amazingly smooth because of its 1.3 quad-core processor and exceptional GPU, which is even better than Acer Zenfone 5 and Moto G. It's amazingly smooth and the touch feels really soft and good. So those are the main things that I like about this phone, and I think any normal day user would also like. Now moving on to the cons about this phone, the bad things that I didn't like, which are obviously are ignorable and are very small, but still I would like to point out them so that you guys should know. The first thing that I didn't like about this phone is same as the Moto G, that the back, home and multitasking buttons are on the screen. Despite the fact that they have all this area here and it's all free, they could give capacitive buttons over here, the three capacitive buttons as we see in other phones, but still they chose to give these three buttons on the screen, which takes this much of screen area, which I really don't like. But anyways, moving on, the next thing I don't like about this phone is that the screen, the actual display, is a bit below than the touch panel. I don't know if you guys can see or feel it or not in the camera, but the display is actually a bit below than the touch panel. And while using the phone, you feel that you are touching the glass above and the things is happening a bit below. Unlike the Moto G, which has the screen almost attached to the touch panel and you don't see any gap while looking at the sides, it feels like you are touching the display itself. But in this phone, if you look it like this, you can see that the touch panel is a bit above, you can say around 1 millimeter, and the display is a bit below. I don't know if you guys can feel it in the camera or not, but that's the case, and that's what makes it feel like a cheap phone like we used to get in the past, like Nokia resistive touch screens. But still it's okay because we are barely paying 6500 rupees for this phone. Moving on, the next thing I don't like about this phone is that when you turn off its display, as you can see right now, the color of the blank screen is a bit silverish, or silver you can say, as you can see right now. Though it's no big deal, but I prefer it to be black color, just like the Moto G. As you can see, the display is turned off, but it's black, or you can say bluish black. But it's not like this silverish. In the black color, it feels rich, like it's a premium phone. But in color like this, it does feel that it's an entry-level smartphone and it's a bit cheap. So that's another thing that I didn't like in this phone. The next thing I don't like in this phone is that you can't play 720p videos in YouTube because of the screen resolution, which is 480 by 854 pixels. And you can't play HD videos on YouTube. I can't show you right now because my Wi-Fi is not working right now, but it can't play 720p videos in YouTube. But if you put a movie or anything, a video which is 720p or even 1080p in your memory card, so the phone player does plays it really well, so no problem in that. So moving on, the next thing that I didn't like about this phone is that while playing a song or music in headphones, the volume is a bit less than other phones. I was playing the same song in the same music app, which is Play Music, and the volume of this phone in the headphones was bit less than Moto G or any other phone. I had to go 3 steps down in Moto G to match the volume of this phone, so that's pretty annoying. Plus the quality of the bass is also a bit soft and shallow than any other phone, so that was pretty disappointing that you don't get enough loudness in your headphones. The next thing that I didn't like in this phone is the camera. The camera is obviously 5 megapixel, and the quality of pics are good while clicked outdoors or clicked indoors at a close range with the flash. Like if you are clicking a pic within the range of 3-4 feet with the flash, so the quality is good enough. But while you click a pic in a low light area with your flash on or off, doesn't matter, the pics are a bit snowy. The main thing that lacks in the images are contrast and sharpness. So the camera is average, and the same thing happens in the video. Though it can record full HD 1080p video, but the same thing happens that the videos are a bit blurry and graining while shooting indoors. And I don't know what's the matter, it does have a 5 megapixel camera, but obviously we can't expect that much good quality in a phone which is priced at 6500 rupees. But still I think that it could have been better than this. Let me show you the camera interface. if we slide it from the left, then we have a photosphere which is somewhat like panorama, and then we have the panorama, and we have the lens blur, camera, and then the video option. Here we have the option of front facing cam, flash, HDR, grid, and self timer. Though I will do include the sample picture which I took from this phone, which you can see after this. So you just saw that the quality of pics are good enough while taking the shot from close range, but if we take it from a long distance, the pics are a bit grainy and blurry, and same happens with the video. Video is even worse, I would say. But moving on, the next thing I want to tell you about is the call quality, which is also average. The clarity is good enough, but it's the loudness that lacks. I wish the speaker could have been a bit more louder than it is right now. Moving on to the battery now, though it's not a bad thing, let me tell you that. It's not the part of the cons or the bad things, I'm just telling it separately. The battery is good enough for this device. It will give you around backup of 15 to 16 hours, I guess, with normal usage. I use it with my Wi-Fi or 3G data on, so I got around 13-14 hours, but if you turn them off in between, so you will get even more. Plus it depends on the screen brightness also, that how much time you spend outside in the sun or a brighter area, because the screen will be brighter that time, and how much time you spend in the rooms or a darker area, because at those times the screen brightness will be less and it will save more battery. So it has an average and okay battery. I had no complaints with it. The battery is good enough for this phone. So that's it for now, guys. That was the honest review video of this phone, Micromax Canvas A1, which you can also consider it as a review of Spice Dream Uno, because both the phones are exactly the same, and I feel that there is no need to compare them either, because there's no point of doing that. And as usual, if you do have any questions, any suggestions, then you can ask them in the comments down below, and I would try my level best to help you out, guys. And if you like my videos, then make sure you give them a thumbs up, because that encourages me a lot. So subscribe for more upcoming videos, guys, and thank you for watching.